Leader, third party.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Honourable Speaker, in September, government raised social assistant rates by $100 per month. Not only, of course, do I support that move, but I also commend government for implementing this increase. Rates have been frozen for a decade, leaving people worse off year after year as their buying power eroded with inflation and the affordability crisis exploded. Nevertheless, Honourable Speaker, while support payments have gone up, the shelter allowances have remained the same at only $375 a month. This is far, far below what it actually costs to find shelter. For example, the organization raised the rates, found that even a single-room occupancy hotel known as an SRO in Vancouver, the cheapest form of housing available, costs $548 a month. And a number of advocates and journalists have documented the appalling and unsafe living conditions that people are forced to endure in many SROs in Vancouver. My question, Honourable Speaker, through you to the Minister of Social Development and Poverty Reduction is this. Do you agree that $375 does not come close to reflecting the true cost of finding shelter in BC, let alone shelter that is safe and secure?
Minister of Social Development and Poverty Reduction.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker, and I thank the leader of the third party, though I did lose the bet on getting a session-free, question-free session. But, Honourable Speaker, I agree with the leader of the third party. People on income assistance, persons with disabilities, and hundreds of thousands of other people who are living vulnerable and living poor are struggling immensely in this province today. I'm proud of the $100 increase that we put in place, the first increase in over a decade for people on income assistance. And as I said, Honourable Speaker, there are significant numbers of working poor in this province who are struggling as well, and I'm excited that at the end of this week, we're going to have a $1.30 increase in the minimum wage, the first step. The first step on the way to a $15.20 minimum wage. But Honourable Speaker, on the issue of housing, the member is correct. It is challenging as we move forward. But we have many steps that we're taking. I'm excited about the biggest investment in housing in the history of British Columbia in the February budget. I'm excited about the increases around rental assistance programs and SAFER grants. And I'm really excited, Honourable Speaker, about the 2,000 modular units that are out there being built today, that are being occupied today, that are helping the most vulnerable people in this province, people living homeless, and giving them a place to live. That's progress and that's leadership.
Thank you, Minister.
So, Honourable Speaker,
Minister, thank you.
Honourable Speaker, the last thing I would say is we're bringing the poverty reduction plan, and yes, we're going to deal with housing.
Leader, third party on a supplemental.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. There certainly was a lot of pent-up answer waiting for a question there. Honourable Speaker, a substantial gap remains between social assistance rates and what is required to maintain a dignified standard of living. That's why, during the election, the BC Greens are committed to transitioning people to livable incomes, starting with an increasing social assistance rates by 50% above 2017 levels by 2020. The previous critic, Honourable Chair, Speaker, on this file said last year, and I quote, "Every year I ask the Minister how on earth they come up with $375 as the shelter allowance for an income assistance, because there's nowhere in BC that's available for $375. Honourable Speaker, I would agree with her, but unfortunately this remains true today, and the average rent of a bachelor apartment in Vancouver is over $1,000 a month. My question again to the Minister of Social Development and Poverty Reduction is this. Will you increase the shelter allowance as part of the forthcoming poverty reduction program and strategy?
Minister of Social Development and Poverty Reduction.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. And Honourable Speaker, we have 557,000 people living in poverty in this province. We have the highest rates of poverty for over a decade and a half, pretty much every year, and certainly the highest rates around child poverty. We have challenges. We need to deal with the affordability questions that the member's talking about. We need to create opportunities for people to break the cycle of poverty. We need to deal with the issues of social isolation and social inclusion for people struggling in poverty, whether they be that 100,000 children living in poverty, the Indigenous and the disabled who are living in poverty. We're going to do that. We're going to bring legislation this fall that will legislate the poverty reduction plan, and British Columbia will no longer be the only province in this country without a poverty plan. We will end that this fall. We will bring the plan shortly after, and we will address those issues of improving the lives of people in this province, including on the housing issue.